Thank you for calling the Sharper Image. My name is Francis. How may I help you today?
Yes, Mr. Bailey, we have the correct address. We'll send that out to you tomorrow.
If you have any other questions, please call us back.
All right, sir.
All right, ma'am.
Thank you for calling the Sharper Image.
Yes, it is, sir. I do apologize.
Welcome to the Sharper Image. We are a San Francisco-based direct response company with expanding retail store operations across the country. The Sharper Image has grown in the past several years at a rate averaging 100% a year to be America's leading catalog retailing company by offering imaginative, high-quality products and unsurpassed customer service. The primary focus of our business is the Sharper Image catalog. Over 3 million catalogs are printed each month, and it all began with one well-conceived magazine ad. President and founder Richard Thalheimer.
Sharper Image started in 1977 with a small magazine ad. The ad cost $200 and netted a $300 profit. I thought to myself, why can't we do this bigger?
In 1978, an ad for a somewhat more expensive watch produced $20,000, convincing Richard he could make mail order work on a larger scale. With the use of targeted marketing, Sharper Image space ads began appearing in national magazines, efficiently reaching the upscale buyer with little time for store shopping. But by 1979, Richard knew that space ads weren't enough. As well as any single publication worked, it didn't allow for rapid growth.
We decided at that point to diversify into a catalog, to get more products, more pages, and spread our risk over many different items. And that's how the Sharper Image catalog got started.
So the first Sharper Image catalog was born, offering several products and individualized space ads in one publication. From the start, the Sharper Image has emphasized sophisticated and intelligent product presentations. Under the supervision of the in-house advertising department, the Sharper Image photo staff creates attractive and imaginative images, while copywriters develop descriptions that are thorough, factual, and highly personalized. Each catalog page is a collection of unique and informative presentations. Like the advertisements, product selection is tailored to the tastes of an upscale audience. Each week, Richard and Company buyers review hundreds of products from around the world, selecting only 1 in 7 to be included in a catalog. Of 200 featured products in each mailing, about 25% are appearing for the first time anywhere. Manufacturers use the Sharper Image catalog as a direct line to the consumer, knowing they get maximum exposure and valuable marketing information, sometimes months before the product appears in normal distribution. Manufacturers also cooperate with the Sharper Image in national magazine advertising, where the streamlined economies of direct response provide considerable support to existing institutional advertising. Anticipating consumer trends and moving on them quickly is a Sharper Image distinction. The company was among the first to offer cordless phones, and when AT&T broke up, the first exclusive phone catalog was born. The Sharper Image saw 50 million Americans developing a new respect for fitness and has provided the means to those ends with a wide variety of innovative home exercise equipment. And in 1983, this investment treasure chest, the Sharper Image Gemstone Catalog, won the John Caples Award for Best Catalog from the Direct Marketers Guild. In 1985, the Sharper Image participated in a joint promotion with a major motion picture for the first time. Roger Moore was pictured on the cover of an issue that featured special products selected to complement the James Bond theme. Company operations have expanded beyond the United States with German, Swiss, and most recently, Japanese editions of the Sharper Image catalog. In August 1986, the Sharper Image concluded an agreement with the Footwear Corporation of Japan. Footwear representatives now deliver the catalog and products personally to the homes of Japanese consumers. While artistry, variety, and marketing skills are the substance of the Sharper Image's success, they are solidly backed by a commitment to the most important ingredient, the customer.
Well, the secret to the Sharper Image is that we look at things from the customer's point of view. We try and eliminate all the hassles and the difficulties that many customers encounter with other businesses. And I often ask myself, if I were an outsider coming into the Sharper Image store or ordering by mail, what would I think of this? And if I don't like it, I change it. A long time ago, I learned that the way to judge a company is not the way they take an order, but the way they solve a problem. So with the sharper image, I've made it my goal to make sure that every problem is solved in a way that makes the customer think, that's a great company.
The telephone customer's first contact is with the highly trained telemarketing staff. The sales information is processed by the Sharper Image in-house computer system and printed out on the customer labels in the distribution center in Emeryville, California. Most orders are shipped in 3 or 4 days. If the customer has a question or problem, a toll-free service line is maintained where a Sharper Image customer relations representative works with the customer to correct the problem.
Right now we have 500 of the rowers in stock and we have 759 outstanding orders. But if I'll put this through as a priority shipment to make sure that you get one of the ones that is in the warehouse and it goes out right away.
Retail operations have expanded significantly over the past year with the opening of over a dozen new stores. The Wall Street Journal report covered this story in November 1985.
Well, anyone with a mailbox has probably figured out that the mail order catalog business has exploded in the last 5 years. But while the number of mail order merchants has increased geometrically, the number of catalog customers has not. That's forced some trendsetters, like the Sharper Image, to look for customers in new places.
If you're a man between the ages of 25 and 45 with a high-paying professional job, chances are pretty good you've received this, the Sharper Image catalog. Products like these have struck such a responsive chord in customers.
It's a yuppie's dream, I think, to possess some of these things.
Catalog's founder and president, Richard Thalheimer, is now taking his merchandise into retail stores. This one at South Street Seaport, located in the heart of New York's financial district, is one of 14 Thalheimer has opened in the last 18 months. Why the big push into retail stores?
I wanted to keep growing and couldn't seem to mail any more catalogs. They just didn't make money. Before we had the stores, I would be mailing catalogs and not be able to take advantage of the goodwill built up among people who don't want to order by mail. And I was letting that resource go.
It's not just a matter of wasting customer goodwill. The fact is, almost 90% of American consumers simply don't shop by mail. They want to see and touch a product before they buy it. That leaves successful mail order merchants like Thalheimer with very limited options.
Any catalog company, any non-store marketer, is bumping the ceiling. There's nowhere to go. He's learned how to maximize the national market in terms of his gadgets or apparel. And to grow, he's got to open up stores.
The number of Sharper Image stores has increased in the past 3 years from 1 to a present total of 27 in almost every major metropolitan area of the country in carefully selected sites. Another 20 stores are scheduled to be opened in 1987. Both the exterior and interior store designs emphasize a clean, uncluttered, modern look. The objective is to present an attractive, interactive, and fun environment, while highly trained and knowledgeable sales associates are on hand to provide expert assistance. The same care that goes into store design and display is taken in the selecting of the location for the store itself. Sharper Image retail stores are placed in or near the business districts of metropolitan areas.
They want to check out a new store in Stamford. It's inside the town center complex. It opened today, and Peter Dench went shopping.
So you say you're a yuppie. Well, tonight, we have a store for you. Let's take a look.
How about the Japanese massage table? A great way to relax for $1,600.
This is the acupressure massage table. There are two mechanical rollers that roll the length of the body, assimilating an acupressure massage.
Some toys.
Every single thing in that store.
So you're looking for an antique jukebox or a telephone that lets you see who you're talking to. Well, don't fret. Channel 7's Eric Smith traveled to the land of yuppiedom and found a specialty store that offers these items and much, much more.
They were busy polishing up the marble over the glass front doors before they opened the exotic world of Sharper Image. Inside, well, one store executive calls it merchandise that no one needs, but everybody wants.
From the Sharper Image store in Quincy Market, good evening, I'm Barry Nolan.
And I'm Sarah Edwards, and this is a popular place. People love to come in here by Faneuil Hall and go through it and play with all the little gadgets. They've got everything, great electronic toys, even a high-tech pogo stick. You want to try this?
You can't do this in heels?
Calories? No, I would try it. I really would. Need some help?
Yeah, that's great.
You can't do it either.
And Deborah Wrigley shows us some gifts Dad may be able to do without.
An automatic water gun.
That's just one of the attractions at this Houston specialty store that specializes in the unusual. For example, this compact closed-circuit TV, perfect for monitoring yourself or even a napping child while you're in another room.
Ross Crystal checks out the latest in high-tech gadgetry. This is the 10 o'clock news.
With nearly 30 stores in operation and over 50 million catalogs mailed each year, the Sharper Image attracts a great deal of national media attention.
Finale. This is really big stuff.
What is it?
Look at that.
Yeah.
And you go 150 to how fast?
Oh, about 6 knots, which isn't bad.
It's darn good.
Want to try sitting up?
Does it get that motor? Oh, there it goes.
Let's get in, Ollie.
Okay. Now, like any sports car, you got to sort of wedge yourself in.
Oh, and it's comfortable, too.
There we go. It's a high lift there. Gotta try this in a full wetsuit.
Oh, props! Props!
We're gonna lower the compartment here.
Ooh.
Are you okay?
Oh, I'm fine. I can put French bread into it, you know.
This comes with a small insurance.
Try it again.
There you go.
More air?
What's it feel like in there?
We're not quite done. About 10 more minutes.
Thank you very much. That really is.
Innovative products, sophisticated presentation, attention to detail, solid customer service. These are the elements that have made the Sharper Image the leader in the industry and will be the cornerstones of growth in the years to come.
Now, the $299 for the robots?
Right.
Yeah, well, if you're going to buy a robot, that doesn't seem to be unbelievably expensive. But then again, do you really want to buy a robot? But $299 is not bad. This is the catalog. Who makes the selections for the catalog? Do you pick it out? Do you have a staff?
I have a staff of 6 people, but every week we meet and go over them and play with about 50 different toys or products.
And what is the one reason that an item gets in the catalog?
Well, usually we try and find something new that people have never seen before.
Yeah. Is it only available through the catalog, or are they available in other stores?
Mostly they're available only through the catalog, and occasionally you do find our products in other stores.
Okay. What else?
Here's something so unusual, probably nobody would want us to put it in a normal store, mm-hmm. but we found that our customers loved it. This looks like a gun, but it's not. It's completely harmless. It shoots infrared light. And if you hold this up and keep both eyes open, you'll see there's a red dot in this sight, David. And when you point it at that target on the desk, I can fire it. So in my office, I can get executive target practice.
Mm-hmm. I can't, I just see the...
There you go.
What am I lining it up with?
You're putting a red dot right over the bullseye and pulling the trigger.
You know, I don't even have to aim it. Look at this. See what it does to the robot. Does that do anything? All right, and this just for a guy...
$150.
$150.
Yeah, would you think that would be a bestseller, but it is.
It is a bestseller?
It is a bestseller in the SHRP Image Catalog.
See, it's people's preoccupations with weapons now. I think people like weapons more and more. Don't you think so?
I think it's a commentary on what they're doing in the executive suites of America, that they make decisions.
Well, that's this way. You probably have a point there. All right.
This is a fat beater. This
fat
measures
meter?
Your fat. This is a $400 version that does it very sophisticated.
$400?
For this.
Yeah.
But what you do is take a grab full of fat here, if you got any.
Ah!
And, like, this shows 12.6... 12.5 millimeters of flab. And you take three different measurements.
Flab?
You take three different measurements, and it tells
you what you do. Come here.
Look, no, hold it there a second. Just read it. 12.5, not bad.
Well, apparently the only reading you can get on the machine is
12.5.
Well, now wait a minute. Why is mine 12.5 a flab and yours is 12.5
muscle,
not bad?
Muscle.
See, you said not bad. Now, what does that mean? 12.5, what do we do
well,
now?
Well, you take three measurements on a man. On a woman, you take four measurements.
Of course you do.
And then let me show you the best product we've got tonight.
Oh,
save this for last.
Oh, yeah. All right.
This is a light sculpture by artist Bill Parker. And this is on the cover.
A light sculpture.
And this is the cover of our next catalog. This doesn't look like much right now. It's like a big glass bowl.
It's a giant bulb. And what's inside? What are the components here?
Well, this has 15 rare gases in it and a microcomputer in the base to turn the gas into multicolored lightning inside this large sphere.
Mm-hmm.
And if we just can get the lights down, I'll turn it on for you. So we'll turn it on right now. And what you'll see
is
some
my
very
God.
Unusual colors and shapes.
Is
and
this safe?
Bring the lights on down if you could.
There you go.
It's perfectly safe, and if you notice, it's attracted to your hand.
May I touch it?
Surely.
Wow.
Now, I'm going to adjust the control slightly just to change the shape of it a little bit. Go ahead and put your hand back on top of it.
Now, this, you say this is safe, but this is one of those deals like in 20 years, they'll release a study.
That's unbelievable. That it looks a little like a hologram or something.
Now, this artist, Bill Parker, is a technological artist.
Wait a minute. The target is going berserk over there. What is that for? What did do that? Turn around. Look at the target.
Well, it is true that this tends to...
My God. Run for your lives!
As long as it stays
something
in the glass...
Something wrong here.
If it jumps out of the glass, we're in trouble. But as long as it stays in there, it's all right. This man is...
Now, this is just electrically charged air passing through gas or vice versa,
exactly.
Right?
Exactly. Very okay. Slight charge. This particular model here is $30,000. It is made only for museums. And what we sell in the catalog is a signed, limited edition, smaller version. It's a foot across for $1,800.
But it is signed by the artist.
This one's signed right in gold on the stalk right in the middle.
Well, it's beautiful. There's no mistaking that, but it's terribly dangerous.
Well,
I'll tell you what, we'll do a commercial. We'll be back, Richard, right back.
Is now 12 minutes after. The Sharper Image is a mail order company that sells luxurious toys and gadgets to men who have a lot of money. Its founder, Richard Thalheimer, has such good instincts about what his customers want that he has basically become a millionaire. This morning, he's come up with a selection of gifts sure to delight a father that you know. In fact, I'm sitting in one right now. Good morning, Richard. Frank's
good
here
morning.
With me, too.
Good morning, Richard.
This is, I guess a recliner is a pretty traditional Father's Day gift.
Well, they call it the getaway chair, and you'll see why in a moment.
Punch the little button.
You want
to turn on my music here,
turn
Frank?
Turn on your music.
If you had any idea what this is doing to my back, it's like little rollers, and they're crawling up my back.
Tell us about
it. I mean, that's a back rub.
It's a full massage.
And it's incredible.
$1,400, though, is the high price to pay, but for the ultimate executive luxury.
Turn it down. How much is it?
$1,400. Who needs Michael with that?
I know. That's right. Wouldn't dare give him something like this. That really is quite incredible. Let's see if I can turn this off. There it is.
I have a toy. There's the power.
You have a toy, too.
Mm-hmm. I love
okay.
it, too. I'm going to
give
the
me a little
issue.
Instruction here. Did I hear the green button? I turn it on?
Just pick up the club there, Frank, and take a swing. This is a practice ball you can use in your own bedroom.
I'm going to move out of his way here.
Do I have it on? Yep. All you got to do is take a swing, hit that little ball, and you'll get an idea of what you would be doing if you were on a real golf course. It'll tell you the length of your stroke and the speed.
Eat your heart out, Tom Watson.
Whoa!
Wow.
What did it do?
And what do you
now
have on the
see.
Display there?
What's on the display?
So you got 142 yards. Now hit the green button.
That's because he plays golf every day.
With the green button in the bottom right there.
With a 3-wood, 142 yards. All right. I must have topped it a little. Oh, maybe I didn't have it on.
736.
Right. Okay. Oh, okay. Watch out, everyone. Whoa.
We got there.
798?
At 79.8 miles per hour.
Okay.
Hit the green button again to see how far.
Hit the green button again. We'll see how far.
Okay.
You hit that one.
158 yards. You're terrific.
He has a lot of practice, though. Come on over here.
It's a 3-wood, 158 yards.
I've got something
proud.
Else for you. What should we do?
This, by the way, is $400.
Oh, it's $400?
For the inveterate golfer.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I have the perfect thing that your husband's going to really want to have for Father's Day. All right. Press his tummy.
These are microcomputer-controlled animals.
And you can talk, right? How you doing?
Or you can whistle.
Whistle to him.
This will sing if I whistle. Listen.
Whistle again.
Oh,
could you die? How much are these?
These are $55, and they'll even talk to each other. Listen.
Okay, once.
Turn that one on. Bye.
I think I just turned them off.
Squeeze his stomach.
I can't stand it. This is really bad when your stuffed animals start talking to each other. I want to see this chess game, though. This is incredible. This is by who? Milton Bradley?
Right, and this has been the bestseller in the Sharp Image catalog this Father's Day.
Okay, go ahead and play it so people can actually see it moving around. This thing plays itself or plays you.
Now
watch
the white
this.
Piece, and it will automatically move its own black piece.
I don't believe that.
Okay, watch. It's unbelievable. When it plays itself, which side wins?
Well,
will it train you, basically, and teach you then?
It plays 8 different levels, and if it wants to give you a clue as to what to move next, you can press the hint button, and it will wiggle the piece.
There it is. It wiggles a piece, so you know which one to move.
I'm going to move my knight now. Let's see what it does.
And it takes pieces away, and it puts them all back.
And how much?
How much is this?
This is a $400 product. We can even make it play itself if we want by hitting the automatic button.
Well, while it plays itself, I do want people to just see one thing. Stand up.
Oh, what I'm wearing.
These are called the extra loafers.
Extra loafers.
We'll just let them lope around just a little bit.
Now, this is the newest thing.
You can get
thing.
A good laugh.
I'd say if I was a millionaire, I wouldn't do that.
This is the newest thing in jogging.
Yeah?
These give you springs on these shoes so that you can take the strain off your knees.
Of course, you might get arrested for being the silliest one on the block.
Well, I've got more attention jogging in my neighborhood wearing these than I ever
I'll
got
bet,
before.
Fun ideas. I'm sure everybody has found something that is perfect for father, right? Thanks, Richard.
Thank you.
From the Celebrity Theater in the heart of Hollywood, it's the Merv Griffin Show. Don't go away. Merv and Rick will be right back with some products you won't believe.
is the time of year when everybody's looking for all those unique gifts for dads and grads. And if you want to get that special person something more than just a tie, my next guest has some suggestions ranging from the strange to the exotic. He is the founder and president of the Sharper Image Catalog, which is amazing. And he's assembled quite an impressive collection of the latest innovative products. Would you welcome Richard Thalheimer? This is Rich Hall, Rich Thalheimer, or Shortheimer.
These are extra loafers.
Those are great. What are they? Do they do anything for you?
Well, they protect your knees while you run. Yet they give you a chance to jog down the street and get a lot of attention.
No way you could fall off those and twist your ankle.
Well, you could. I'm not going to demonstrate that tonight, though. $130. So like ski boots.
Great.
$130. But the best thing about them is they're good practice for skiing or running or ice skating.
Love them.
Or ice skating?
Yeah. Well, they're good because they build up your ankles.
Your ankles.
Oh, ice skates do.
Out in the West, they don't know about ice skating. As long as we're right over here, get on this. This is called an acu-massage table.
Yeah.
You don't need a therapist. You just do it all yourself. Do you know how it works? Just get on there. What happens?
That's right. Well, you're going to lie down.
All right.
And inside this table that looks like an ordinary bed are rollers that simulate fingers. So just like real fingers.
Like the Motel 6 has
is
those.
Is this a legitimate massage?
Well, I guess.
Is something happening?
I'll see.
Now you notice.
What is happening? Describe it to us now, Rich.
Well, you notice his body is gently rising because there are rollers underneath here that are rolling the underneath of his body. Now watch as this comes up to the middle of his spine.
Holy cow. Oh, boy. A new sensation?
Now watch, this one's coming up right here. See that roller right there?
Well, that's normal breathing, isn't
there's
it?
There's the eighth vertebrae, there's the ninth.
Hop up and let us show them what it looks like underneath here, Rich.
So what's happening?
Well, if you pull this pad up, you'll see the roller mechanism actually rolling down.
Oh, look at those little devils going up and down.
See these right here?
Yeah. Whoa!
You want to try this?
No.
Great.
Yeah, no. That is like a big, what do they call those things in carpentry? I guess so. That's good. Show us what you got over here.
Well,
just hop on over. Are you stuck for the rest of the show?
I'm going to take these off while you play with this.
Okay.
This is the world's most advanced light sculpture called Star Sculpture. It is literally electricity trapped inside with 15 inert rare gases. These gases are so rare that 1 liter costs $250,000 for 1 liter of gas, but this whole product only costs $1,200. So there's 15
what
rare gases
use?
Inside. Well, it's on right now, but you can't really see it until you turn the lights down. So I'm gonna take off my shoes, and you play with it by rubbing your hands across it and moving the slides over here. Rub
actually,
your hands across
ooh,
it.
Look at that. Now, I'm not gonna go sterile, am I? Richard, is this measuring my gas? Oh, try it, Rich. Maybe you'll make another color than I. No, we're both orange. And what did he say to fool with down here?
Those little slides along the front. You can slide them back and forth.
Okay. I'm going to give you a full shot now. Look at this.
Holy cow. Look at
that.
It's like the old ABA basketball, isn't it?
Yeah. $1,200 for the privilege of having this. Now, Rich?
Well, this just came out in the brand new Summer Sharp Image Catalog, and we're going to sell about 1,000 of these in 3 months at $1,200 each, which is amazing when you think about it.
Psychologically, does it do something for you?
Well, I think what it is that people like the power of controlling what looks like a lightning bolt. When you get this lightning bolt effect, see if I can just tune it up real fast for the lightning. See, there you go. When they get this lightning bolt going, they really get off of this power.
Ooh, look at that. Are you sure that's not coming into your body?
Well, this has been tested by different bureaus of the government, and they have found that it emits no microwaves and it is safer than a color television.
It's funny, it has a strange effect on me.
Gee, that is odd, isn't it?
Good.
light.
This has been described as Boy George's nightlight. Now, here's an interesting product that's just the opposite end of the spectrum.
It's a good machine.
What? This is so high-tech. Here's one that's a little bit simpler. This is called the two-potato clock.
The two-potato clock.
Now, you notice it's a holder that can hold two items, such as a potato.
Yeah.
And it has a little LCD display in the front that is not running right now. But to make this clock run, I'll just stick a potato on one side, and I'll put a potato on the other side. That's why it's called the two-potato clock.
It's not running.
There's no batteries of any kind. Well, let's take...
Is this a C or a D potato? Which C?
Now, it comes with four prongs, so I'll put one prong on each side. Still not running. Last two prongs. Put one prong on one side. Put the prong on the other side, and the clock should come on.
It did. That clock runs on a potato?
Can you believe that? There's no batteries. It just runs on the acidity in the potato. And as long as the potato is still wet and whole, it'll run for about a week or two.
What else will it run on other than a potato?
Well, I brought along to show you a different material altogether, probably more suited for some of the audience and most of America. Let's take some beer.
You're kidding.
Let's just put a little beer on each side and see if it'll run on that.
So while the old man is watching football on Sunday, he could be running the clock?
That's right.
Huh?
Exactly.
You're kidding.
So let's drop our two probes in, one on each side. Whoops, let's see what color we got. First, we put a black probe on this side.
I see.
And then drop the last probe in.
And the clock comes on.
How about that?
There, you football widows. That is good.
How about that?
Okay. Now, what are we going to do? Are we going to pull this or push this off? Pull it this way? Okay. Because behind the curtain, I hear there is the most amazing item ever from the Sharper Image catalog. The curtain.
The world's first personal...
Are you being covered? Wait a minute. Get under the boom here.
This is the world's first personal hovercraft. It sort of looks a little bit quiet just sitting there, but we're going to actually hop in and demonstrate it. So you sit on the right
seat. For land or water?
For both. Land, water, or snow. So sit in the right seat. You can just hop in anywhere.
Anywhere?
Why don't you hop in the back?
How do you get in?
Take a big stretch there. Sit in the middle and the back there. So sit on the right side.
Yeah.
You can go down the freeway in this?
You can go down anything.
Would that shake him up?
Turn the lights on.
Yeah.
And this goes over water.
Ah. Put the wires in him. This goes over water and land.
Water, snow, swamp, bog, mud, desert.
How far above the ground?
Floats 12 inches above the ground.
And it runs by air.
It runs, actually there's a Volkswagen engine propelling a large fan, and it runs about 50 miles per hour. Consumes
You've
only
15, gotta be kidding.
15 miles per gallon, only consumes about 15 gallons per mile.
I took one gallon. One time, but it was a big ship from like, is something happening?
Ready to see it run? Did I say it goes 50 miles per hour? Did I say that?
Be careful, there's an audience out here. Image catalog, and our thanks to Richard Tallmeyer and to Rich Hall. We'll come back after this message. That is...
These are about $9,000. They go, get 15 miles to the gallon, and they go 50 miles an hour. Have a nice weekend.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
This is Business Times on ESPN.
Here's our technology report for this morning. Catalog shopping is becoming a way of life, but for the direct marketers who publish catalogs, mail order sales evidently aren't enough. And they're finding that if they really want to push their products, they've got to use a range of new technologies to stay ahead of the pack. We asked our San Francisco correspondent Lawrence Wilkinson to talk with one leader in the field, the Sharper Image. He filed this report.
Here, in its San Francisco showroom, are the products that fill the Sharper Image catalog, products that have fueled the growth of the company's sales from $500,000 5 years ago to an estimated $100 million in 1984. The Sharper Image is one of the country's most successful direct marketers, but its growth is only slightly more impressive than the growth of the industry as a whole. Since 1976, catalog sales have risen from $16 billion to an estimated $46 billion. All direct marketing, including also direct response and bill stuffers, has grown in the same period from $75 billion to $150 billion. The number of catalogs has risen so rapidly in those years, from under 4,000 to almost 7,000, that the average household now receives over 80 per year.
One of the fun things about the catalog business is almost anybody can get into it simply by thinking up a specialty, make it original, and make it something that you know something about. And you can start a small catalog in a very small way. The person that receives it in their mailbox has no idea if the company's sending out 10,000 or 10 million.
Direct marketing revenues are currently about 14% of all retail sales, but they're growing at twice the rate of more traditional retailing and are projected to be 20% by the end of this decade. Companies like the Sharper Image have capitalized on two trends. The first is the move toward boutique or specialty shopping.
Certainly it's true in the mail order business, you've got to have an original image. You can't look like everybody else. If you can't do something original, I'd say don't do it at all. And at the Sharper Image, we try and reflect a lifestyle, a professional managerial person's desire to own certain products.
The second trend, as manifest in the exploding use of 800 numbers, is the growing concern among consumers for convenience.
The history of our country and our civilization is one of time compression, people doing more in less time. And we have to cut down the amount of time we spend. People can't spend 3 hours going shopping and coming back in an age when 3 hours becomes an enormous period of time.
Experts see even more convenience for consumers and even faster growth for direct marketers in the coming of new technologies. The Sharper Image already reaches customers with television and cable. But broadcasting, along with the video text and video disc kiosk experiments underway today, may offer only interim solutions. Thalheimer is banking on the home computer.
Biggest change we're going to see coming in the next few years is the merger, this marriage of television, the telephone, and our computers. The computers are going to give us the ability to interact and to have two-way communication. The television screen is going to let us see what the catalog or product is. And the telephone line will give us a direct connection between our computer and some store. So time has become compressed, and someday it will only take 10 minutes to go browse and shop, but only when the electronic store is here.
From the Celebrity Theater in the heart of Hollywood, it's the Merv Griffin Show.
This is the time of the year everybody starts thinking about buying gifts for that person who has everything. With me right now is the young man who can be of some help. He is founder and president of the Sharper Image Catalog, which contains some of the most unusual and innovative products in the world. And today he's here with a sneak preview of some of the more off-the-wall items that inventors have brought to him. And they work. Would you all welcome Richard Thalheimer. Okay, you start anywhere you want.
Well, Merv, this is what looks like a small Volkswagen van.
Yeah?
But
it's the actual size, isn't it? Small.
Now, this is not the ordinary toy. I'm going to put it down. I've got an old record here. Not too old.
Yeah.
I'm going to just set it down here.
Then we're going to push the antenna up.
That's me singing.
Now, this is the kind of gift you want to give to anybody with an antique record collection.
But that is absolutely amazing.
Now, if you want stereo, you buy two cars.
Now that is called a sound wagon. It sells for $40.
Bargain at half price.
Well, actually, we didn't think that was quite price right, but next year, you know, with depreciation, it'll be down to $29.95 with just a few miles on it, or a few revolutions.
Right.
Now, out in front here, I've got our robot. This is an RBX5 robot.
You know, robot was an RBX5.
This is a baby robot, though. Robots are in their infancy.
This does everything?
No, actually, it does practically nothing because it's a baby robot.
Well, it just made a mess over there.
Now, you could turn this on simply by flipping the switch here. There's a switch right there.
Do you talk to it or anything?
Well, the first thing it'll do is...
Which switch?
This little switch right there.
I think the one that says on.
First, it does a little dance. Now, it'll say something. It says, to enter command mode, press 2 and 4, but we're going to press 1 and 4 to give it a slightly different command. Okay. This is 1, and this is 4. Now, if you press them simultaneously...
These two.
Mm-hmm. It says, excuse me, I'm hungry. And it starts looking for its plug to plug itself in. Now, right now it's looking. If it runs into something, like your foot or a wall...
Excuse me, I'm hungry.
It says, excuse me, I'm hungry. And it goes off looking for its plug.
Excuse me, I'm hungry.
I'm tired.
Now, does this come with a human to translate?
Well, again, don't forget, this is an infant robot.
Oh, I can think of 100 uses for this thing.
Now, this is...
The price on that.
This is expensive, $1,795.
But it's a bargain at twice the price.
For a baby robot that doesn't do anything?
You know what? I want a robot that can lift up the car and put it on the record.
This over here is the vacuum that this robot can pull. You see, it attaches here, and then it pulls the vacuum along.
And it cleans the whole house.
Cleans the whole house.
Oh, for $1,700, cheaper than
a man. You can't beat it.
No.
Now, step over here to the scale.
Okay.
Scale.
First, you want to turn it on, Merv, and then step onto it.
Turn it on.
Right. And step on and listen. Go ahead and step
onto
it.
Don't you have to put on one of these?
No, just go ahead and
go ahead, Ollie. Step on.
Now, press M1.
No, M2.
M2, bad news.
Bad news?
No, it says only one at a time,
Murph. Oh. Oh, vicious. Get on there.
All right, Ollie, I'll get on the scale. This is a beautiful thing. And the workmanship involved in this thing. Look at this. What?
Press it again.
Press M1.
Press M1.
M1, bad news.
Uh-oh, bad news.
See, the nice thing is you can just kind of wring its neck.
That is $6,000.
It's a beautiful, well-made
thing. So that's $129.
Now, look at this hat.
It's a pith helmet.
A pith helmet.
Do you notice anything unusual about this hat?
It has a speech problem.
We'll put this on Jay.
Put it on Jay.
All right, Ollie, I'll put the hat on.
Okay.
Now, I'm going to take a light bulb.
Boy, it certainly is warm in here.
Oh, it's got a sonar panel.
I'm going to pretend
top.
That this is the sun. And we're going to shine the sun on
Let's
the top of the helmet.
Oh, there's a little fan on.
Oh, yeah.
Can you feel it?
Now hold still so you can see the fan.
Yes, boy, it's...
Cool. It's got a little fan right
there. Whoa, it's getting chilly in here. What a wonderful thing that is. And you know what it is? As you walk through the desert, see, the fan can just blow dust in your face.
Sure.
You do is you put your water right here on the sponge.
Uh-huh.
And then you have portable air conditioning.
Ah.
Well, the nice thing is, too, you see, you can strain your spaghetti through here also.
If you're in the desert, $99 on that
That's
one.
Right.
Only 99.
Yeah.
Now, here's the world's most expensive and sophisticated tape measure.
Tape measure?
We'll let you try this one.
Okay.
You point it at the blue wall over there.
All right.
Hold it like that.
Why don't I point it at Jay?
Well, it won't read humid. It only reads walls.
It only reads the walls.
Maybe so they can see the readout.
Yeah.
Now, put your finger on this button here and hold it while you're pointing it at the wall.
When you see the button. Okay.
Okay, now hold the button in.
What's it say? 13 feet 7 inches.
That's right. Hold it there so they can
see. Well, let's check it out to see if it's right.
Where are we going to get 13 feet?
Huh?
You know what's good about this? See, the nice thing about this is...
That.
See, I'll show you. Let me show you.
Mm-hmm.
See, this is good for guys. You go into a bar, let's say.
Yeah.
Okay? Now, a lot of time, women will wear those big caftans, and you can't tell what's under the caftans. You just go, hell, too wide. Thank you.
The price on this?
Yeah.
$249. That's
it's a
not
steal.
Bad for a carpet. It's still talking.
It says, help me, I'm broken.
All right. Now, here comes the big surprise.
What else
oh, geez.
awfully sorry we're breaking all of the things from...
Who says the Americans can't make a good product?
Where do you see this one? All right, here's the finale. This is really big stuff.
What is
Look
it?
At that. Look up to your bathtub. Wow.
You have to appreciate that.
Now, listen to this. This is serious.
The Sharper Image catalog is full of toys.
Yeah.
Once in a while, we find toys that are just
a moth
the most amazing things. This one is designed to let two people cruise 150 feet underwater in perfect comfort.
In perfect comfort?
This is a submarine. Now, it doesn't have a bar. It's not a wet bar, exactly.
Yeah.
But you're wet.
You'd be full of water.
Up to the waist.
Oh, up to the waist. Ah. And you can go 150, but how fast?
Oh, about 6 knots, which isn't bad.
It's darn good.
You want to try sitting up?
Get that moth. Oh, there it goes.
Let's get in, Ollie.
Okay. Now, like any sports car, you got to sort of wedge yourself in.
Oh, and it's comfortable, too.
Well, wait. There you go. The high lift there. You got to try this in a full wetsuit.
Oh, props! Props!
Now, we're going to teach you how to drive this.
I feel like a weeble.
And the first thing you do is turn the lights on here.
Lights on.
Okay. Now you can operate your front dive planes by moving this stick.
Hey.
There you go.
Hey, it's moving all right.
Now you adjust your depth.
Suppose it's the whale mating season. Is it possible?
I think that's why they painted
it orange. Well, brace yourself then.
Okay. A short beat is all.
Oh, Jeff! One more time. Good.
What is that?
That is how you adjust the depth, the ballast.
Ah.
Oh, I see.
Now, let's try the...
Oh, we're still on the same thing.
Let's try moving to the rear now by operating first the rear propeller right there. You can flick that to the upper right-hand corner.
Oh, there's a space. Oh, pull in there.
Is it going? You turned off the power. You can operate the left and right rudder in the rear.
Am I doing it?
You are. You're actually flying.
And back in.
Oh, I love it.
Hold it. Hold back. Oh,
okay.
Back it.
Okay.
Now, this is a kit that you build yourself at home. Amazing.
It doesn't come like this?
No, the Sharper Image is going to send you these packages, and you put it together, but it's somewhat pre-assembled.
How much?
Only $7,200.
Oh, but what a laugh you could have at Malibu. Huh?
Yeah. Wait till you see how it feels when you're actually inside.
Okay.
We're going to lower the compartment here.
Ooh.
Are you okay?
Oh, I'm fine. I can put French bread into it. You know,
this comes with a small insurance.
Try it
policy.
Again.
Okay. There you go.
Hello, Ollie. Are you there? More air?
How's it, what's it feel like in there?
We're not quite done. About 10 more minutes.
Thank you very much. That really is a wonderful collection of new electronic inventions. And we'll come back right after this message.
A generation ago, you bought crystal sets by catalog. It wasn't until about 10 years ago that the Hochschild collection came out offering crystal and other elegant things for the home. Now the business is changing quite dramatically, and you can buy diamonds by catalog. One of the most interesting practitioners of this new art is the Sharper Image. We have Richard Thalheimer, who's the president of the Sharper Image, to tell us about the business. Richard, how is it changing? Tell us that, would you?
Well, the catalog business has become an upscale business, they call it. That means more expensive items offered in a wider range of products, things you would never buy from a catalog before.
That's right. Everybody was suspicious about catalog sales. Things got lost in the mail. There was no delivery. There's no trust in the business. But that's changed. And why should people do this, though?
Well, I think it's a reflection of our lifestyle. With two
Two-income families.
Families working nowadays. You know, the woman doesn't go out and shop for the man anymore. The husband never was that much into shopping to begin with. Mm-hmm. And so catalogs are a way to have things sent to your home and not have to spend that time.
I think you mentioned one other thing to me just a minute ago, that if you have a catalog, you can actually put the merchandise in the catalog and start taking orders before the item is even produced, cutting down the lead time, in a sense, so that you can get your really forward-looking items in the catalog right away.
Well, from the consumer's point of view, it gives them a chance to see what's new first. The retail distribution chain is often a long one and takes as long as 2 months to fill up. A catalog can show the product at the prototype stage. At the same time the catalog is being printed, the product is coming into the warehouse.
I see. But now, is it true then that the reason that you have one advantage is because you're saying, I know it'll be in Bloomingdale's another couple of months, but we're going to have our customers with it in their homes before Bloomingdale's or some other leading merchandiser like Neiman Marcus, somebody even has it. Is that the edge you have, or is that
true.
The only edge?
And not only that, Bob, but a leading mail order company can often get an exclusive for 6 months to a year before the product is even shown at retail stores.
Well, now, why would a manufacturer want to give you an exclusive like that?
Because a catalog like the Sharper Image goes to maybe 7 million homes each season. And to get that kind of exposure nationally may be better for the manufacturer than having just a little distribution in a few cities here and there in major department stores. In addition to that, they may not have enough product to support it for the first year. The example of that is the Sony Walkman television, which was in very limited supply the first 6 months.
So you were able to offer that, were you, before others did?
Right, exactly. Mm-hmm. They'll just give us a product first.
Mm-hmm.
They have limited supply. They want to get the maximum publicity.
I see. So you offer that publicity. Mm-hmm. But now, where do you get your mailing list? Do you just buy mailing lists and so forth, or how do you do that?
Well, is anyone
smiling as though this is a secret?
Oh, I'm smiling because anybody that's ever bought by mail knows that rapidly your mailbox is filled with other catalogs. And that's because mailing lists are rented.
Well, what's going to prevent me from taking this rather attractive catalog and just saying, that's another one of those things I don't want any part of my mailbox, right?
Well, it is a fact, you know, that 98 out of 100 of these end up in somebody's wastebasket.
And you don't care because that 2% will carry you through. Is that the idea?
Well, I suppose another 15 or 20 look at it. But I bet you half of them never even get looked at.
The only test, Richard, of this kind of thing is how good the business is. I'm not going to ask you how good your business is, but is it possible that there's an investor angle here, and is a company in this business profitable enough at this time to draw investor interest?
Well, we haven't made a secret of our company's growth. We've grown from nothing to a $100 million business in 5 years.
I see.
We're very proud of that.
That is very substantial.
Oh, it's amazing.
But is there a public?
There are very few pure mail order public companies in the mail order business. Williams Sonoma is a well-known gourmet cookware company.
Mm-hmm.
Went public about 3 months ago, mm-hmm. and amazingly, it's been selling at 45 times earnings.
45 times earnings. Now, that puts it in the high-tech category.
It's amazing.
Why is it selling at that price, you think?
Well, until the bloom slightly went off the high-tech mm-hmm. industry, people always felt mail order was too low-tech to be worthy of attention.
Mm-hmm.
Since that slight shift in mood, people, investors, are looking for new areas. They figure that mail order is a growing area, and historically, the last 6 years, it has grown double the rate of other retail businesses.
Now, let's go through the figures again. You're up to $100 million, and you mm-hmm. started back in $5 million how long ago?
In 1976, we did about $250,000 worth of business.
Nice.
If you double that every year for 6 years, you get to $100 million, which is where we are right now.
So would you say that this company, name it again, the one that's up to 45
Williams,
times earnings?
Williams-Sonoma.
Williams-Sonoma.
Mm-hmm. They're on the over-the-counter market.
But wouldn't you say the stock is overpriced at that level?
You know, it's about the only pure mail order play there is. And I think people,
right.
quite frankly, are looking to get into mail order investments.
That must be inspiring you to move in that direction sometime soon.
Oh, we'd love to look at the public markets, but we've got to complete this year, have a good solid result, and maybe think about next summer.
Mm-hmm. Is the company profitable?
Well, we managed to net about 2-3% after tax 4 out of the last 5 years, so that's
okay.
been a good result.
That's a good result for the catalog business. Is that what you're saying?
Well, it's not 10%, but 2-3% and doubling your growth every year, I think, is great.
Thank you very much, Richard. Something Ventured guests are booked with the cooperation of Venture Magazine. We'll be right back with more of The Market Today. Please stay with us.
Hello, everybody. I'm Oprah. century. You know, 2.5 weeks from today, Christmas will be over, Hanukkah will be underway, and gifts will be open. But between now and then, we're all going to labor over just what we're going to buy for the people on our holiday list. Well, get out a pen and a paper, because today you're going to see some of the hottest holiday gifts for kids, the newest electronic gadgets, sensational furs and jewelry, bargains for any budget, perfect gifts for husbands to give their wives, and great gifts for wives to get their husbands. And almost everything you see is between $5 and $5,000, with a few exceptions. They beep and they buzz, and they're the type of gifts everyone loves to try out as soon as their wrapping paper comes off. They're the newest electronic and high-tech gifts, and here with a great selection is Dale Shepherd of the Sharper Image. Welcome, Dale, here to the show. So watch this. You do this. You record your voice. You go, hello, 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 and then you play it back on this little Casio, and he goes... Great. That's great. Okay, we're going to get a little music in here?
We'll get a little music going here.
I love it. Great. $129.
$129.
Okay, show me some
other
things.
What do you want to play next? Let's go over here.
Okay.
This is a remote control ball.
Remote
control ball.
Yep. Everybody needs one.
That's right.
Okay, put it up here.
Put it up here?
Uh-huh.
All right, let's sit it down. We'll turn it on.
That's great.
Takes a lot of practice, but once you get the practice down, it's a lot of fun. You can drive people crazy with it.
That's great.
There it goes. That's
why you need to practice. That's okay, right. Great. Okay, next.
Is that fun?
Okay, great.
Let's turn this off before it goes really crazy.
Okay. What is this?
It's a massager.
Mm-hmm.
Turn it on.
Whew. It's a Mack truck coming through your brain. Oh, it feels good.
You ready?